The NFC East is so unsettled that these last four games, and it starts tonight with the Dallas Cowboys, mean the world to jobs.
Yeah.
Not just, you know, are we going to win the division, or are we going to get in the playoffs, or can we make a run? It's like, dude, am I going to be here next year?
Mm-hmm.
It's a different feel for all four of these teams in the East. And, I mean, the Cowboys are the most, most heightened one because of what their owner has said repeatedly, inconsistently, and contradictorily about their head coach, Jason Garrett.
But also because of their talent and because of their start, even if it was against bad teams, we get that.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, when you have one of the best running backs in football, you know, a top 3, 4, 5 offensive line, mm-hmm. when you've got, you know, Amari Cooper, when he's right, is probably top 10-ish, top 12 receiver, maybe 9, maybe a little bit better than top 10, maybe.
Top passing game in the league.
Yeah, you got a lot going for you. I mean, you got a pretty decent kicker, you got a great home field, you got a weak division. All these things would suggest Dallas should have run away with this division. They should have buried the Eagles. This should be, and I said this a couple of weeks back, this should be about home field advantage throughout.
Mm-hmm.
This should, the way the Cowboys are set up after their start and their talent base and the circumstances of their division, it is criminal that they're not on cruise mode right now, chasing 13 wins, 12 minimally,
mm-hmm.
and making sure you're getting a bye and playing in one game. Maybe not the NFC Championship game up at home, okay, but the divisional round, that's supposed to be held in Dallas, or was supposed to be held in Dallas.
It should have been.
Now they're lucky if they get in.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah. I mean, look, the wild card may be held in Dallas if they win the division, but that's still up in the air. I mean, I think the bigger question, you know, as we look at this Dallas Cowboys team, the schedule that they faced, that they started with, which was cake, we talked about. Then it got rough, right? The teams with winning records who they couldn't beat, they were good teams that they had to play. And now you get to this point in the season. Traditionally, they're playing on Thursday night, so that's, you know, it is what it is. But then they follow right back around and play on Thursday night again. It feels a little bit unfair. Not really, because they actually have the full week. But traditionally, after you play on a Thursday night, you get the weekend.
Yeah.
Right? So
I'm not going to shed any tears for them. The Raiders didn't play a home game for 2 months.
But BT, they knew this. They've known this for 2 months.
Yeah.
So it's not like, oh, wait, we have another week?
Yeah. And this logistical
snag. Agreed.
It's not the beginning of their malaise.
No.
I mean, they've been playing poorly before this was presented to them.
That's right.
I mean, the Bills just eviscerated them. The Bills smacked them. So, you know, I'll tell you who's got – I know that we keep going to Jason Garrett. I get it. You know who's got pressure on him tonight? Dak Prescott. Win the game.
Mm.
I know that your team's playing poor. I know that the Bears are playing the exact opposite. They have won 3 out of 4.
Mm-hmm.
I know Trubisky's showing some decent signs of life a little bit. He didn't completely crumble. I know that the Soldier Field fan base is going to be lathered up. I know the Bears' defense is, if not very good, it's good. If not borderline great. I mean, it's borderline elite, I should say. Go in there, all right, and the first time you get the football, engineer a 90-yard drive or an 80-yard drive, you know, eat up 6-7 minutes, punctuate it with a, you know, a thunderous play, whether it's Zeke off left tackle, a bang in the end zone, or, you know, hit Cooper on a slant and have him waltz it, score a touchdown first. And all this stuff that we talk about with Dak Prescott, is he the one? Is he really truly a lead? Is he worth $35 or $40 million? Those answers will be settled. But before those answers come, win tonight.
Yeah.
Beat the Bears.
Yeah.
Just beat the Bears, dude.
Well, that's the
That's it.
Well, there's, I mean, you talk about the pressure. The pressure on Jason Garrett is his job. The pressure on Dak Prescott is he wants to be a $40 million a year guy contract. And if he wills them, if he puts it on himself, and they go down these last four games and they're 10-6 and they host a playoff game, get to the division round, maybe even win that one, then we're saying pay Dak whatever you want.
Which franchise quarterbacks do
often.
That's
exactly right. It's what they're supposed to do.
Yep.
It's why you when after the early struggles, just to go back to the Giants of Eli Manning, once he got to the postseason and started just dominating, you're like, all right, dude, he's worth it. Right?
Sure.
Pay him. Whatever it is, pay him.
Uh-huh.
And it paid off for the New York Giants. The Cowboys are still, I think, in some people's minds, figuring out, is this worth it? Right? Is it worth it? Yeah, he's good. He's leading the league in passing. Got 3,700 yards already. He's got
great.
5,000.
Yay, terrific.
Exactly. Maybe 35 touchdowns he's going to have on the season. But does he win the games that he's supposed to win?
He better start tonight.
And that's what he's got to do tonight.
Yeah.
They're supposed to beat the Chicago Bears, even though their records are identical and the Bears are playing better.
I agree. I really do agree. I want to play this cut. This is You go back to back on this is about the leadership aspect of is that a problem, D-Cell? Can you not go back? Okay, you can go back to back, right? So the first one's gonna be Jason Garrett talking about Dak as a leader, and then Dak Prescott talking about their playoff fate. Because again, you know, I don't need to see 420 yards tonight. Just win the game.
Doesn't
set
matter.
The tone.
Lamar Jackson.
Reverse the narrative.